I want to give different voltages. The first one is BGS. What it is called?
BGS.
Now BGS, okay, BGS some voltage. Then next one is VDS. Okay. First VDS equal to 0. First VDS equal to 0 means what? Very simple and just we can connect like this. We can connect like this. How we can connect this one? Okay. Our what is our basic phenomena? This is N channel. Charge carriers are what? Electrons. How it leave from the channel? So this N charge carriers, electrons are leaving this terminal. If it is leaving this terminal, which terminal is preferable now?
Negative
means it is what? It's repulsive. Okay. If you connect to positive terminal of the given battery, these electrons are trying to attract this positive terminal. Indirectly, this drain bar is what? Drain bar is leaving the current or leaving the charge carriers from the channel. So better we can connect to positive terminal, then next negative, positive, negative. Okay. What happened now? Yes, this is N channel, this is negative terminal. So what happened? This negative terminal is always trying to oppose the charge carriers. Then this whatever we have the charge carriers. In this what are charge carriers? Electrons. Electrons are trying to move from source to drain. Okay, then obviously drain current flow like this. Nothing to worry about drain current. Just you concentrate on charge carriers. It is moving from source to drain. Why it is moving from source to drain? Our basic phenomena is what? Drain terminal is used for leaving the charge carriers from the channel. Is it possible now? Yes, obviously. The N electrons are attracted to the positive terminal. Is it right or not? Okay. What about the second terminal? This negative terminal is used to enter in the channel. Okay, that's fine. Now, VDS equal to 0. Now, come to the VDS. Now, this VDS is also done. So, this can be put as a what? 0 voltage. Come to the VDS. Okay. What is this VDS? This is one terminal. Okay. This is one terminal. And this one is another terminal. Okay. Now, this is what? P-type. So, I want to VGS is decreased from 0. What is this word?
Decreased from 0.
Decreased from 0 is nothing but we can apply reverse bias. Okay. Or reverse voltage. Or reverse current. Even
machine.
Negative voltage. Okay. Decreased current 0. From 0. So, decreased current means here you can connect as a reverse bias. How we can connect reverse bias? This P type is connected to which terminal?
Negative
terminal. Very good. This is negative terminal. Then N channel is connected to what?
Positive
terminal. That's fine. Okay. This is negative. This is positive. This negative terminal is connected to the P type. The positive terminal is connected to the N type. Now it is forming which bias?
Reverse bias.
That is fine. You know one thing. This P type. This is N type. This is formed one PN diode. That's fine. This is P type. This is N type. This is also formed one type of PN type. What is our original phenomena? PN diode is connected in reverse bias. What about the depletion region? Okay. Here place two important parameters. One is the channel. Second one is the depletion region. Okay. Second one is the depletion region. These two parameters plays very, very major role. Okay. Before going to these two parameters, first of all, I want to give some example about reverse bias and forward bias. First of all, forward bias. Okay. If we connect PN diode in forward bias, what about the depletion region? If it is forward bias, the PN diode does not exist any depletion region. That is means what? There is no depletion region in forward bias. Coming to the reverse bias. Reverse bias means it forms some depletion. Okay, it forms some the depletion. Okay, exists depletion region. Okay, what are the two parameters? Channel and depletion. For example, first VDS is tends to zero. VDS is tends to zero means what? There is no current. There is no current from source to drain. Okay, there is no. Okay, of course, current in the form of drain to source. There is no movement. There is no moving the charge carriers from source to drain. That's okay. Now coming to apply VGS zero to decrease. Okay. If for example, if you apply VGS, just simply we can connect some RPS regulated power supply, some 0 to 10 volts. Just you can apply input voltage. Here what? This is what P type. This is what N type. So what happened? How it is converted? Now here forms one depletion. Okay, what it is called? Here forms one depletion. For example, how it will be converted? Okay, this is one P type. Okay, this is what N type. This is what N type. Okay, now I want to apply VGS. Okay, what it is called? VGS. For example, VGS, I want to apply some minus 1 volt. Why it is called minus 1 volt? It's a reverse bias, right? Reverse bias. For example, if I apply minus 1 volt, it forms what? Depletion region. So now it's converted into like this. Okay? It converted into like this. So this is nothing but what?
Depletion region.
Very good. Okay. Why it forms depletion region? Because of you applying the voltage in input side. That's why it is forms the depletion region. Then same what is done here, same process also done here. Okay, same process is also done here. This is what depletion region. Before going to the depletion region, one more parameter is also existent. This is called channel. Why? Because N channel JFET. So previously, what happened channel? Channel is as it is occupies same area. Okay, this is nothing but area. So if you apply the VGS, the channel size is reduced. Why it is channel size reduced? Why this arrow mark down indicates means what? Channel size is reduced. If it is channel size is reduced, means indirectly depletion region is increases. Okay, then coming to the next stage, if you are increasing your words, decreasing from VGS from minus 3 volts, then what happened? Okay, this VGS is increased to minus 3 volts. Okay. Minus VGS is equal to minus. Now we can apply VGS equal to minus 3 volts. Now what happened? Again, depletion region somewhat increases compared with the old voltage. Nothing but minus volt. Now again it forms like this. Okay, again it forms like this. Okay, this is fine. Okay, better you can draw one wedge shape. Okay? One wedge shape. This looks like what? One wedge shape. Right. Okay, if you further increasing the VGS, so again if increasing the depletion region, whatever the depletion region, increasing the voltage means what? Of course, decreasing from zero is indirectly increasing the voltage. So VGS is increased minus 3 volts. Then what about the depletion region? Depletion region is also increased. So if its depletion region is increased, what about channel? Channel size is decreases. Okay, now again channel size is decreasing. Okay, again you can increase. VGS is equal to minus 5 volts. Then what about the channel? Okay, the channel is almost completely disappears. What about channel?
Completely disappears.
So that's why there is no channel. If you increasing the VGS voltage or decreased from the zero, there is no channel existed in this channel. So there is no channel means there is no charge carriers moving from source to drain. So here VDS is almost going to cut off range. What is it called? Going to cut off. So that is called VDS equal to 0 volts. So nothing but VDS acts as a cut off. It is called VDS acts as a cut off. Right. Okay. Now, can you understand? I think there is no charge carriers moving from source to drain because of what? There is no charge carriers moving from source to drain means what? There is no voltage.
Okay.
The, here this channel is goes to cut off VGS. Okay, right, that's fine. So that's why VGS equal to 0, VDS equal to 0, VGS 0 to decreasing from different voltages, VGS minus 1, VGS minus 1. So, can you think like that? Okay, now I want to explain about again same phenomena. Okay, now VDS is increased from 0, VGS is kept constant. What happened if you can't like this? Okay, same phenomena. I can apply same phenomena. Okay, very good. Now finally the depletion region gets like this. Okay, finally the depletion region gets like this in the first condition. Okay, again redraw our original figure. Okay, original figure. What is original figure? This is highly doped with p-type material and highly doped with the p-type. P plus. This is channel N, this is channel N. Okay, this is source,
this is
drain terminal. Now, our motto is what it is called VGS equal to 0. Now, VDS, what it is called? VDS. So, VDS equal to means what? VDS is 0, you can apply small voltage, here it is, just you can apply 0.1 or 0.2 or 0.3, whatever it is, if you apply any such quantity of voltage, immediately we get current. How it is current? So because if you apply the voltage, whatever the charge carries is always trying to repulse here, then this source terminal is used to enter the charge carriers into the channel, then leave the charge carriers from the drain terminal. So immediately we can expect drain current from this applying what? VDS. So if you apply the VDS, we get immediate drain current. Okay, immediate current. That's fine. Okay, now I want to some extension of this one. Okay, now parallelly I want to increase the VGS. Okay, parallelly I want to increase the VGS. For example, if I kept VDS equal to some 1 volt, right? VDS equal to 1 volt or VDS equal to 4 volts. Now this is some final point, VDS equal to 4 volt, that's fine. For example, if I increasing the VGS, so what happens of this drain current? Drain current is increased or decreasing? Yes, it's very important phenomena. For example, you can apply both voltages. One is what? VGS. This is what?
VDS.
Now, I want to apply both voltages at a time. For example, if you apply VDS, what happens? ID current flows at what? Drain terminal. For example, if you apply the VGS, then what's the original step? It forms the depletion region. So compare with the original ID current. Now it's very difficult to move charge carriers from N side, this source side, to drain side. Why it's difficult to move charge carriers? Because of here depletion region increases. If depletion region is increases, the channel size is decreases. If there is no channel, highly impossible to travel charge carriers from this side to this side. Okay, the further increasing of VGS, there is, if you go on increase of your VDS, there is further increasing of VGS, the further increasing of EDS, yet sometime ID becomes to zero. Okay, what happens? If increasing the VDS, if increasing the VGS, VGS increasing means what? Decreasing from 0 to some voltage. Okay, that time we get what? ID equal to 0. When it will get ID equal to 0, that VDS voltage we can also call as a pinch off voltage. So what is nothing but pinch off VP equal to 0. Now coming to the characteristics. For example, this is we can take VDS at voltage. Before going to the characteristics, first we concentrate on circuit diagram. Then we can understand how we can draw the characteristics. Right, very good. This is clear about the operation, everyone. Very simple and easy. If you increase in the VGS voltage, the channel size is reduced. If it is channel size is reduced, there is no further movement of charge carriers from source bar to drain bar. That's the fine. There is no ID current. There is no ID current means ID current is zero. At that time, VDS is zero. That VDS is zero is nothing but what? Pinch of voltage. That's why we can call this, this is nothing but pinch of voltage. That it can be understandable. Now, we are going to the circuit diagram of the JFET. What it is called? Circuit diagram of the JFET. Okay, very simple and very simple. First, we can draw like this. Okay, this is one terminal. This is one terminal. Which circuit are capable? N channel. Right. This is N. This is which terminal? This is. So, this is what? This is? Source. This is? Drive. Now, if I want to connect the circuit diagram, RPS is preferable. RPS is preferable. Okay, this is what? Gate terminal. So, this is N channel. Once go into a little bit flashback. This is what? This is channel. This is what? P. This is what? P. This is N. This is what? Source. This is L. This is A. This P is what? Reverse bias. So P is connected to the negative. Okay, this source is N. So N is connected to the what? Positive terminal. Okay, so gate terminal is connected to which terminal? Negative terminal. Is it clear? Why it is connected to negative terminal? This is P mark. P is connected to negative terminal. It forms the reverse bias. That's why it is connected to the negative then positive. Okay, this source is connected to the positive terminal. Right. So this drive terminal. So this is N channel. It is trying to leave from the channel. It's trying to leave from the channel. Means what? N terminal is connected to very good positive terminal. Why? These charge carriers are trying to attract this positive terminal. Right. This negative terminal is connected to the source. So, source is connected to the what? Negative terminal. Drain is connected to the what? Positive terminal. So, drain is connected to the positive terminal. That's fine. Then, this is called the common source also we can call. Because of the source is grounded. Common source or common grounded. Right? Source grounded. Now, this is also power supply. Now, which parameters are plays very major role in this operation? First one is what? VGS. The second one is what?
VDS.
The third one is ID current. Now better this ID current here. Okay? ID current here. That's fine. Now, what happened? How we can measure this VGS? How we can measure this VDS? How we can measure this ID? Very simple. If you want to calculate VGS, simply we can keep voltmeter parallelly gate terminal and source terminal. This is nothing but what? VGS. It is called VGS minus and plus. Same. This we can connect to what? This is what? VDS. Okay. VDS. Plus and minus. If you want to drain current, just simply apply here ID. This is, these two are voltmeters, this is ammeter. Now it is very easy to measure or parameter. Now our first operation, for example, just based on this circuit diagram, we can see this characteristics. Very good. If this is x-axis, this is y-axis. Fine. In this x-axis, we can take VDS value and this value. In y-axis, we can take this ideal. First, VGS is fixed at 0 volt. So, if it is 0 volt, immediately the conduction is started. Why? Immediately conduction is started, there is no channel. There is no channel. Okay, channel is existed, there is no depletion. Why it is immediately start the conduction? There is no depletion region. Channel is maximum. So based on this maximum, so we get large current. We can expect here like this. Up to some extension, we get also some breakdowns. That one we can understand why it will get breakdown. Again, if you increase it or 0 to decrease it, so VGS is tends to minus 1 volt, channel size is what? Channel size is reduced. Why? Depletion region increase. That's why we compare with old VGS, it somewhat decreases of IV. That's why it will get like this. Again, further decreasing of VGS, again ID current also decreases. Again, increases of VGS, the ID is also decreases. So finally, these characteristics we can also call output characteristics, okay, or drain characteristics. Why it is called drain characteristics?
Because
we can measure the drain current. That's why it is also called drain characteristics. Finally, at one point, it is almost reduced to zero. How we can calculate? Okay, now it's okay. That's fine. For example, this is maximum current ID. If you further increasing of VGS, at one particular time, increasing VGS. Ma, listen. Increasing VGS. ID current means what? Decreasing. Increasing the VGS. ID current what? Decrease. Increasing the VGS. ID current is. So further increasing of VGS. This is important for VGS. So if you go on increasing the VGS, highest ID current is decreases. Okay? This is decreases. So this is nothing but transfer characteristics. This is drain characteristics or output characteristics. This is what? Transfer characteristics and this is only transfer characteristics. The transfer characteristics is drawn between VDS and ID. Why VDS? VDS. This is VDS. No. This is VDS. That's good. This is VDS. If you increasing the VGS, what about ID? ID is almost zero. So further increasing of VGS, the ID current is zero. If you draw between ID and VGS, that characteristics is nothing but transfer characteristics. If you draw between ID and VDS, that is nothing but the drain characteristics. So this is very important to study the characteristics of FET. What we are now discussing, operation of the FET, types of the FET and characteristics of the FET. Okay, next class we have discussed about the FET characteristics. Once again we discuss the FET characteristics and parameters of the FET. Okay, thank you.